Hi, welcome to Artomania. This drawing is of an eagle, and I'm going to show you how to do it step by step. First step is an oval, tilt it slightly up, bring a line off, coming off the circle, and round it at the bottom for the head. The tail comes off the oval on top, straight line on the bottom, and then connect it to the oval on the bottom. And then the legs are coming off the bottom right where the head ends. The first one is kind of squarish, and we're leaving a little bit of a line at the bottom for the feet itself. Same thing for both sides. The wing, you want the first one curving out. That line doesn't look right. Okay, this one. Notice how I left the line even though I wasn't satisfied with it. You do that and it's a little bit easier to place things, and then you can erase it later. For the front wing, it's coming off, it's a bit bigger, but it ends at the same place. For the bottom bit of the wing, we're going to draw a half line curving around and leave a little space in between the first line we drew for the wing and the last. And that will become the place where it connects into the body. We're going to draw the beak now. For the beak, you want to start in the middle of the face and get a small hooked line. The eye, there's kind of a line going back, and then the eye is underneath that line. Now we draw in the bottom part of the beak, which is just a straight line coming from the bottom of the head. For the feet, it's just a simple X. For the top part of the wing, we just want the lines curving, following about the same line up, but with two different curves. And then like spokes of a wheel going around all to the same point. And these will be the top part of each feather. And later we'll draw in the bottom part. And remember, this wing's further back, so you'll probably want the spaces in between to be less than the next wing. And that's the wing muscle. Now we're gonna draw in feathers, top part of the feathers for that. Remember, it's going around that like a spoke, but you want each one curved as well. And you don't want it to be circular, you want the middle feather to be the longest one. Breaking up the tail. Now I'm drawing in the bottom part of each feather. Just cutting it down, the pencil down, and getting a really easy effect, actually. You might need to replace some of your feathers. You didn't get it the first time, and that's fine. And then you want smaller feathers coming off of the bottom half of the wing. And on the very bottom here, you don't want any feathers. Now, I erased the bottom of each feather and then later added in a jig-jagged line for the smaller feathers. You know how an eagle's wing has really big feathers and small feathers? Okay, let's move on to the tail now. For the tail, it's about the same process as the wings, but instead of cutting the bottom half back, you want to bring it straight over. Shoring up the leg a bit, adding in little jig-jag lines for the effect of feathers. The feet themselves are not jagged, they're very smooth. You want some ruffled feathers on the head as well. And the eye is really important to make the bird look angry and like it's about to attack something. Another jagged line, curved around the head, shading on the bottom,
It's 6 o'clock.
Your beak. Oh well. Forget what time it is. Okay, here I'm drawing in the jagged line for the smaller feathers. And you don't want it too defined. Background, you can draw whatever you want for a background, really. Thanks for watching Artemania. See you again soon, hopefully. Hope you enjoyed this video, and hope you learned something.